KTH has been a huge part of my life. I studied here, and then and what I learned, I took with me for the rest of my career. So it was a great honor when I was invited to celebrate KTH's 100 years. And as she introduced, I will guide you through my story of how the financial ecosystem has evolved during the same 100 years period. And we have went from a very local physical market to a global computerized world. As a person, I'm extremely curious, and I studied computer science because I wanted to be part of this journey. I'm a useless person to just maintain something as status quo. And when I started 98, and that was still in the beginning and early days of computers and digitalization, and I just thought, this journey, I want to be part of this journey. So, before I go through the 100 years, I just want to give you some perspective that how trading have started and what's actually formed our capital markets as of today. So trading has been part of the human being for many, many, many hundreds of years. And this was how it, for many years, looked like. You went to the marketplace, you brought your goods with you, you traded it, and you came back home with some money or another part of goods. And it was all a physical market. In the end of the 18th century, Stockholm Stock Exchange was built, and then you can actually you moved indoors, and you actually could trade some securities. So not only what you as a farmer, for example, produced, etc. One of the, so 1917, that's when KTH was born, and one of the first technical innovations that actually made a change for this industry was the telephone. And as I said before, it was a physical market. You had to go there, you had to bring your goods with you, you had to take your goods back home. And around 1917, there was 150 participants connected to the Stockholm Stock Exchange that by telephone could actually participate in the trading and get information of the prices and information that was formed at the exchange. And this was a massive change because it meant that you could have a distributed market. Not everyone had to be present. And I would say that technology, if you're just looking at the financial market, the financial ecosystem, the capital markets, you could think that it's formed very much formed by the business people and the people who studied finance. I would claim that they might have had a huge impact, but to actually take this market forward has been only through technology. And this was the starting point. But then it didn't happen that much on the technical development side. We went through the Wall Street crash 1929. We went through two world wars. We recovered in Europe during the 50s and the 60s. We had a Cold War. We landed on the moon. But still, it was a pretty manual or very manual process in the way we traded. And the telephone was our only technical tool. But in the 70s, 80s and 90s, from that onwards, we have actually had a pretty rapid and journey and change in how the capital market has evolved. And in my view, that is purely because of the technical evolution and the technical development. And in the 1980s, Olof Stenhammar created Optionsmäklarna, OM. And they were the first privately owned, profit-driven electronic exchange in the world. And that actually was the starting point for Stockholm as a fintech hub. So currently, you can read in the press more or less daily about Stockholm and fintech and innovation, etc. But it started already around 1985 when we in Stockholm developed the first electronic trading system ever. And this has been pretty known abroad, but it's a pretty when you go to London, New York, and you talk to people, and they always ask me, what is this thing with Stockholm? Why are you so much in the forefront of developing the system to the financial ecosystem? While in Stockholm, it has been pretty unknown up until now. I think it is because we have a very strong engineering culture. We have very good technical universities, and we have a very good working mentality. And this has been a crucial part in actually not only for Stockholm, but for the financial market globally. And another thing, so when OM was created, they started to trade derivatives, so not only equities or physical goods, etc. And that also means that prior to that, a lot of the traders come from the finance, they studied finance or something. But derivatives, then they realized that they were much better off if they recruited people that actually studied at the KTH, mathematicians and quants. So KTH has been an important role for the technical development, but also from combining the understanding that business side and understanding the technology. And I'm a believer that technology is nothing in the context of nothing. It doesn't matter. I mean, you can sit there and you can build your most fantastic system, but if that doesn't solve a problem, if that doesn't sort out the use case, then what should you use it for? But by combining the business understanding and the technical understanding, that's when you can actually move forward and use technology to move the market forward. And that, I think, was an important component, that you brought that side in to this world. And I talked to a colleague when I was preparing this, and he was part of the... he worked at the OM at that time, and he said, you know what, we call them super brainiacs. Those were the guys from KTH that could calculate these derivatives as a machine. And that was actually the starting point of HFT trading and robotic trading, because you brought that niche and you met in that crossroad. And then it moved on, and this was about the time when I graduated. The past I read in the books, and this is actually something that I've been part of and seeing and been part of transforming. And the exchanges, they introduced then electronic trading. They closed down the manual trading floor. More and more was automated and digitalized. And for example, Goldman Sachs, they had 600 equity traders in the year 2000, 600. But in February 2017, they had two. They were all replaced with computers and systems. So this was actually, or have been, a huge shift in competence. So prior to that, the financial markets needed traders. Today, the financial market need developers, quants, mathematicians. And this is a picture from UBS trading floor in Stanford, the world's biggest trading floor. It was big as 23 basketball courts. And you can see the transformation and how that was actually replaced with technology. And as part of this, so during the same time frame, a lot happened with regulation. So the markets was also deregulation. You open up for competition. And as we all know, competition is very often a catalyst for innovation. So this meant that the incumbent exchanges, there was more or less monopoly markets and member-owned and had been there forever, and they all of a sudden had to spell to competition, and they all of a sudden realized they had members and customers. That wasn't something they were used to. So, it was very was a pleasure to be part of that journey and to deliver system to these new startups that actually had no legacy, that looked at the world with another set of eyes, that could see, so they could run and operate an exchange with something like 20 to 30 people, and they could be profitable, and they could develop their business much quicker because they have better and more modern system than the legacy exchanges that were thousands of people and weren't really used to competition, weren't really used to change something because the members wanted it. So it was the deregulation also did a big shift in the capital market, in the financial market, but it was all driven by it was technology that moved it forward. And then, I don't know if all of you remember, but in 2008, there was the Lehman Brothers collapsed, and that was the starting point of a long financial crisis. And that was an eye-opener for many, that we needed to introduce transparency and control. So in my world, there shouldn't be a single new financial crisis because the lack of system. So if people have bad economies, if you do bad business, that's one thing. But not realizing your risks in the market, not realizing your positions, not that shouldn't be the reason for another financial crisis. So we should build systems that prevents that, that indicates, and that actually makes the much, much more secure and robust infrastructure. And if we move on from that, then the I would say that was the introduction also of algo traders, because now when the exchanges got competition and the competing the newly started MTFs and exchanges, they competed on speed, they wanted everything to be much, very much quicker, and they attracted a new set of customers, which was the robots and the algos and the HFTs. They have many names. And then it was a huge debate for many, many years whether this was healthy or unhealthy, whether it was good or bad. But in the end, someone has always been first. So the big debate was about being first, get the information first. But that has also in the manual trading floors, there was always a guy that was bigger and taller than the other that could shout higher, etc. So in my world, it's just... Now it just happened to be about technology. And so the world moved on, and those algos was introduced. And of course, when things goes much, much quicker, then you can take... If you build up risk, if that took you a day before, now you could build up risk in seconds. So, of course, you then have to have other types of surrounding systems. And the core systems by the exchanges, they weren't ready for this. So they weren't investing in the same type of speedy technology that the traders were. So that's why we then had incidents like the flash crash, which is gives a negative impact on technology because a lot of the noise and the voices in the market and the industry, they blame technology for this, while my thought process is that if everyone just kept up with technology, it wouldn't have happened anyway. And technology, it's inevitable to stop. You can't stop technology. The technology will transform our planet in all shapes and form, and exchanges have been no different. So then you can see what's next and how do, this is the 100 years, and if you look at that and if you go back even more, the actually how the market has changed is in the end, if you spread that timeline out, it's in the end, it's when technology has been available, that's when actually move the market. And there is many, many more technologies out there. We will constantly change. There is no way to stop it. We have AI, we have blockchain, machine learning, we have cloud-based, and that's just the names we know about today. Tomorrow there will be something else. And I think that the financial industry and the capital markets, they will develop very rapidly. I do think that institutions like KTH and similar will have an even bigger impact tomorrow, because today, up until today, you have educated people that's being part of building these systems. In my world, those types of people haven't always been involved in the decision-making process. So if you're looking around globally, it's no difference anywhere. And you're looking at the management team at any bank, any exchange, any clearinghouse, any financial institutions, you don't see any Mark Zuckerberg. You don't see a lot of engineers. You don't see they having studied computer science or something. But they're coming from the finance industry. They studied finance, and you need that competence too. But if you're looking at where they make money today and where they're going to make money tomorrow, so coming from A to B is all about technology. So if you're then going to take decisions to take yourself from A to B, and the decisions is about technology, then you need that type of competence. So I think that I would be super happy. I hope I will be 200 years old. And if I be, the researchers think that the first person to be 200 years is already born, and I hope it's me. But if I do, I might stand here in another 100 years when you're celebrating 200. And I hope that KTH will continue to play the important role that it had had so far in the global financial ecosystem, and that you continue to develop on the engineering side, but also in the context of finance, and that you're combining this crossroad. And then I think Stockholm will be a fintech hub for another 100 years. Thank you very much.